Hi everyone and welcome to this video. In this video you're going to be looking at how to use lambda functions in Python. Now lambda functions are just anonymous functions that have no names. For example, normally when you're creating a function with Python, you may do something like def and then name the function, then we give in some arguments and then we can also specify what this function may return. Now with lambda functions, we create functions that simply don't have any name. For example, if I were to recreate the function right here, what I would do is actually to say, let me say my function is equal to, then I'll use the lambda keyword in Python. For example, I would say something like lambda, and then I provide the argument. And in this case, the argument is going to be x and then y. So let's say x and y. And then I specify what happens, what this function basically returns. For example, I may say that this function is going to return x and then y. So an anonymous function is a lambda function and doesn't have a name. So if I were to call this, I would use the variable my function to actually go ahead and call this function. So I can just come right here and say print, and then I'll specify my function, and then I give in the arguments, for example, x and y. So if I came right here, I can actually come and say that x is going to be, let's say, 12, and then y is going to be 13. So when I save this and run our example right here, we are now going to see the output of this function. So for example, in this case, we now see the output of 25. Now let's also go ahead and create a simple function that basically multiplies two numbers. So for example, I can just come right here, can call this my function 2, and actually just say my func 2, and this is going to be equal to a lambda function. So this is going to be lambda, and then it's going to take in the values. So in this case, let's say x and y, and then you're also going to specify what this function returns, which is going to be x multiplied by y. So a lambda function can take in multiple arguments. In this case, we're actually using two arguments, that's x and y. So if we return this, I can say print, and then this is going to be my function 2, and then I specify the values in this case. So for example, I can say 3 and 2. Now when I run this, I'm going to comment the previous example. So I'll just come right here and comment this and run again. So I'll actually run it manually this time with python main.py, and this is going to return 6 because now we have our two arguments x and y being 3 and 2. Now let's look at how we can write a lambda function that can take in more than two arguments. So actually I used two arguments for the first example, but let's say I created another lambda function. Now let me call this lambda function 3, and it's going to be lambda. Let's take in x only, so this is going to actually return x. So when I just do this, so what this actually means is this function is going to take in x and simply return x. So when I go ahead and print this, I'm going to say print, and then we shall print my function 3 to the console. So when you run this, we expect to get the value of 3. So right now we see that we actually calling a lambda function, we haven't yet called it. So to call it, I'll simply call it and then specify the value, which is going to be 3. So when I come and run this, we are going to get our answer as 3, meaning that our lambda function is returning the value of x, which is 3. Now let's look at a practical example in which you can use lambda functions. So I'm going to go ahead and remove all of that. Now, after removing all this, then we're going to go ahead and look at how we can use lambda functions. Now, take a scenario in which you may want to create a function to run within a function. For example, let's say we want to create a function called my function. Let me actually call it my function. And then this function takes in x. Now, let's say you wanted to multiply this function, this argument or this parameter with an unknown number. In this case, let's say y. So what you may actually do is to just return a lambda, and then you specify the argument, and then you multiply it with an unknown number, which you don't know in this case. So I'm going to say that this lambda is going to take in the unknown number, and then it's going to return x multiplied by the unknown number. So in this case, which is going to be our y. So for us to call this function, what we can do is to call it simply, just like we called. So what happens is we first call the function that we know, which is my function, and then that will go ahead and also invoke the lambda function that we created. So for example, I can say that my multiplier, and this is actually going to be, let me call my function. So I'm going to give in the value of x, and then let's say the value of x is going to be 2. So I am going to also call this. So for example, if I say print, and let's say my multiplier. So in this case, we want to call the my multiplier function. Now, in this case, we have to specify our value for y. So we can actually come and say we're going to call it with my multiplier, and then we provide the argument as 3. So when I come and run this with Python main.py, we now see that it's returning the value 6. So this is happening in a way that, let me close this. So what's happening is we have our function with a known value of x, which is 3 in this case, and then we're multiplying it with a value of y that we don't know of, and we provided this as 3. So let's say we wanted to actually call this with other values. So for example, I can come and say print my multiplier, and then right here I'm going to specify 4. So when I run this, we now see that it's returning 8 for the second case. Now let's also look at how we can be able to use this with lists. So I'm going to create a simple list. I'm going to call this my list. And then here I'm going to specify values, different values. So what I'm going to do is to say 1, 2, 3, let's say 45, and then let's say 63. And then let's say this is going to actually return, actually, let's say also 23. So we can also use lambda functions with lists so as to be able to filter or do functions on top of what we have in our list or the elements of our list. So for example, we can go ahead and filter out numbers that are actually divisible by 3. Now to do this, I'm just going to come right here, and what I'll do is to say that let's actually do it this way. So what you're going to do is to create a list that's going to contain the values that are divisible by 3. So I'm just going to call this div 3, which is going to be the list, and this is going to be a list of whatever is within our list but is divisible by 3. Now to do that, we can use the filter keyword or the filter function. So we're going to introduce our filter statement or function right here. So the first thing it does is to take in the function it's going to execute to check for the values of x. So in this case, we're actually going to use our lambda function, and then we're going to provide the argument. So in this case, we can say x, and in case our x is divisible by 3, so we can say x modulus, and then we say 3 equals 0, meaning that it's going to check for any number that's divisible by 3. And then we're going to actually specify an iterable, which is going to be our list in this case. So to do this, I'm going to come and say that we're going to have my list as our iterable. So when you try to print this out, I'm going to come and print div 3, which is going to be our set of numbers that are actually divisible by 3. So when I come and run this, I'm going to say print, and then actually it's going to be Python main.py. We now see that it's actually returning values that are divisible by 3. So this actually shows you how to use the filter function with the lambda function. So lambda functions can come in handy in case we just want to write anonymous functions that help us to do Python one-liners. So also going to look at another case. So let's say I want to return a number that are divisible by 3 in this case. So to fill it with some numbers, I'm going to fill it with 44 and let's say 100. So when I come right here to do that, I'll just say, let's say divisible by 2. Actually, let me use a clearer name in this case. So when I do this, I'm going to come right here and I'll do the same thing. So we're going to use our filter function, and then we're going to specify a lambda function that's simply going to filter out those numbers that are divisible by 2. So I need to provide an argument, which is just simply going to stand for any number within the list that's divisible by 2. So in this case, I'm just going to come and say x modulus, and then 2, and if that is equal to 0, then it shall provide the entire ball as the second adjoint. So in this case, it's going to be my list. So once we have this, I'm just going to come and print this. So when I come and print divisible by 2, and this is actually going to work the same way. So I'm just going to come right here and say Python main.py. So this is actually going to return a filter object. Let's see what we've done here. So this is a filter object right here. So we actually have a mistake here. So actually having a filter, this is actually supposed to be a list. So I'm going to correct this. And this is actually going to return our list. So right now we have our list of numbers that are divisible by 2. So we've learned how to use lambda functions in different ways, and we actually need to actually see another way. So for example, we are going to look at how we can map each of the elements in a list, and then we do something onto that. So we're going to be making use of the map function. So to do that, I'm going to, let's say, return numbers of, return every number in our list, but then we're going to maybe subtract 3 from it. So to do that, I'm just going to simply come and say that sub 3 or subtract 3 is going to be equal to a list. So I'm going to actually say that this is going to be a list. So I'm going to say map, which is also a function. It also takes in the lambda function. So I'm just going to come here and say lambda. And then I specify the element, which is going to be x in this case. Now I'm going to specify what will happen to every member in our list. So for example, in this case, I'm going to specify that for every member in our list, we're going to actually raise to the, actually we're going to subtract 3. So I'm going to just say x and then minus 3. So it's going to subtract 3 from each member. And then in the second argument, which is going to be our iterable. So for example, I can actually come and say this is going to be my list. So when I do this, I'm going to come and print this out. So when I print sub 3, it's actually going to return the list of numbers subtract, we read subtract 3 from each. So when I come and run this again, we now see that's actually returning every number in our list, and then it's returning the result of subtracting 3 from each of these numbers in our list. In this video, we've been able to look at how we can use lambda functions in Python. We've also gone ahead to look at the various cases in which you can use these functions. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and share this video with others. Don't forget to like this video as well as to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye.